Well, no doubt you recognize my guest today, News 4's own Michael Cogdil.
I hope so.
I'm sure that they do, and I'm glad you're here. In fact, if you want to stick around and finish the show out with me on the anchor desk, I'll
be glad.
No, but you know, this
is not my hour of the day. I don't know if I'm fit to be on live TV today. Good morning.
You're doing good. I'm glad you're here, and we're going to be talking about your new book. Everyone's familiar with your writing. Yeah, we'll show it off. Want to start off, you're an anchor.
I am. Very
different than writing for a book.
Very different.
How is it switching the gears from news journalist to a fictional writer?
It is beautiful. It is a wonderful thing. You know, the news is a hard thing, and it is so often gloomy. I don't have to tell you, the viewer. And so I would go home, having done the late news, and retreat into the world of She-Rain. And there is some gloom in She-Rain. There are hard times in here, but I wrote this book, Kelly, to be a tome of hope. And there's a love triangle in this story. There are two women in love with the same man. My wife, Jill, inspired those two women. And I wanted to show what's humanly possible, that a love triangle can rise into a firmament of great hope and great light. It doesn't have to descend into the worst of our longings. And I didn't write it, you know, to fit into the news of the day. There are a lot of love triangles going on.
But so this no is inspiration one. There from
no, me. No, but this is one that'll give you hope, I promise.
Well, before we get into more about the book, tell me about the title, She-Rain. It's a different title.
She-Rain is an old mountain folklore term. I'll be curious to know how many people know this, especially up where I'm from, Western North Carolina. This is Grandfather Mountain we're looking at here, by the way. My grandmother told me about She-Rain from the time I was a little boy. She-Rain is a little wisp of fog that'll break off from a cloud and ride along the treetops on a ridgeline in Western North Carolina, and really anywhere in Appalachia. And she would look at that and say, look, honey, that's She-Rain. Isn't it so beautiful? And I remember thinking from my earliest times, She-Rain goes without fear, goes with the wind. It's a great sort of symbol of faith. Really. It's
so
not afraid to fall.
How does that fit into the characters that you write about in your book?
The characters who are in She-Rain are born into hard times, in the clefts of Appalachia, into some darkness, into some gloom, but they rise. They rise and they move beyond it. They move beyond a beautiful place, and they take that place with them. And one of the great messages, that to me, it's great, the messages of this book is you don't have to live down to the worst of your times. To the worst of the things that people say to you or about you, don't let them take root in you. Rise above them and go in faith. You know, She-Rain moves in faith. A little cloud, it is not afraid to fall. It's not afraid to fly. It just goes. Go, 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 go.
As you convey this message, what is the time period the book is set in?
Starts in the early 20th century. Most of what happens in here happens just before 1929.
Okay.
And what we wanted to do is really showcase people who are far ahead of their time. I have an African-American woman in here, young woman, way ahead of her time. I have a Presbyterian minister in here, way ahead of that time. And it starts in Western North Carolina. It starts in the mountains, but it ends on the coast. I love the mountains so much, but I love the coast, too.
You had to get them both in there.
I did. Had to.
You were telling me before the show the preacher that you write about is actually, there's a real-life preacher that was the inspiration for this
character.
There
is. His name is Bob Lawrence, the Reverend Bob Lawrence, who's the pastor emeritus at the Fourth Presbyterian Church here in Greenville, South Carolina. And he inspired me so, so very much. He's such a dear, dear friend. And he inspired Rev Lou in this book. When you see Rev Lou, it's not entirely Bob, but there's a lot of Bob Lawrence in it.
What about him inspired you for this character?
He is so real, down to earth. He walks with a real world faith. He brings it down where everybody can understand it, and yet there is such an elegance to the man. There's such an elegance and a grace to him, sort of this voice of God, and you just want to listen to him forever and ever. And in civil rights, he was way ahead of his time. During that period.
A lot of good things in your book. We are going to have some information about it posted on our website. Michael, it's been great to have you here this morning.
The honor is entirely mine. Thanks for putting up with me, folks. You know I do the late news, so this is not my hour of the day. Thank you so much.
If you want to give it a try, it's not too late to come over there and join me.
That's right. And I'll be signing at the Barnes & Noble shops at Green Ridge this afternoon, 1 until 3. If you show up, you know, wake me up. I'll be kind of nodding off by then, but I'll be very, very glad to welcome everybody. This will be the first signing of the book, and let's see. Oh, yes, there. But wait, there's
more. You have one next weekend as well.
I do. Fiction Addiction. Yeah, you saw Jill Hendricks there. She's been a great, great partisan fan of this book and friend of ours. And next Saturday. And there's at the Trillium Arts Center, well, as a benefit to the Trillium Arts Center and Traveler's Rest, we have a great event coming up at White Oaks, which is the Furman President's House here in the next few weeks. And so
great.
Reach out to the Trillium Arts Center. We want to raise them some money and raise some awareness of them as well.
So if they want to ask about the book, they can also maybe ask about what you do here at the station too, right?
They can. Feel free.
Michael, thank you.
You're welcome.